critics of the Marcos Jr. administration's proposed sovereign wealth fund again picketed the House of Representatives Monday. That didn't stop the House Committee on Banks and Financial Intermediaries from approving House Bill 6608, or the substitute bill that contains the latest set of changes, chief of which 20% of net income must be earmarked for social welfare programs.
I think it's something na dapat tingnan natin sa implementing rules and regulations natin. Pero kami, ako, to be honest, gusto ko yung ganun, yung diretsos tao, ayuda, support, subsidy sa tao.
The bill also imposes liabilities and penalties on officials who misuse the fund or commit gross negligence, which includes jail time of 1 to 5 years and fines of 50,000 pesos to 2 million pesos. It also prescribes which are allowable investments, which include infrastructure projects and those authorized by the board. However, they cannot take over active management of companies where Maharlika invests.
Always naman kasi, when you invest in good companies. Good companies that are well managed. So why join the operations kung maayos naman yung management ng company? So I think yan yung wisdom of the author, why nilagay nila yun. It's just an additional safeguard para in the event na may ganun, bawal siya.
That's aside from other safeguards.
Meron tayong COA, meron tayong external auditor, meron tayong internal auditor.
Other amendments include reverting the name to the Maharlika Investment Fund, while the corporate entity will be called the Maharlika Investment Corporation. It also formalizes the replacement of the President of the Philippines by the Secretary of Finance as board chair and the new composition of the board.
I would agree with the Secretary of Finance kasi yung vision eh. If the President is from the private sector, hindi ba yung vision ng country natin kung saan tayo papunta? Mas maganda yata from the Secretary of Finance manggaling yung direction na yun. Where we can invest, anong infrastructure, di ba?
Tieng isn't bothered that the changes in the initial investors in the fund cut the capitalization by more than half.
Diyan natin makikita yung galing ng mga professional managers na ipapasok nila dito sa ating Maharlika Investment Corporation. They have to make the fund grow. They have to make the money grow for us. So, ako naman naniniwala ako na, yeah, enough na yon. And in the event, makita natin in the next few years na maganda, di tingnan natin from there again, i-review natin.
House Bill 6608 has been submitted to the plenary for deliberation and eventual vote on second reading. Over at the upper chamber, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said President Marcos Jr. wants the Senate to seriously consider crafting a law that would create the Maharlika Investment Fund with the objective of boosting the country's investment climate.
Sabi ko naman kay Presidente, Mr. President, medyo alam mo naman, mas matagal talaga sa amin that we go through it like a fine-tooth comb. We will look at the House version and of course possibly add amendments to assuage the worries of our kababayans na magkaroon ng leakage, corruption.
RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.